Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of WWE 2K17 Universe Mode. And right here, Chris Jericho is coming out. It's been a long time since doing an episode. We're actually back. Of course, right now he will be facing Samoa Joe after numerous attacks on Joe. It seems only fitting. And that they're about to clash right now. There he is. Got him a brand new attire off Community Creations. It's based off his third run attire. I see third is pretty accurate. But you know whatever. And here he is, he will face the Destroyer, Samoa Joe. Very interesting to see in real WWE. How the feud between Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens is gonna go. I want to see it bad. I want to know what's gonna happen. But right now we got Chris Jericho versus Samoa Joe. Now it personally really kills me how enthusiastic Chris Jericho was to get into this match. Anyway, this is the first time I've ever done a Battleground pay-per-view, so I usually count it as one of the less important pay-per-views and replaced it with a different one, but I decided this time to keep it, because, you know, why not? Why not keep Battleground? Now, if you want to know about the pay-per-views that I am changing, I will be changing Fastlane still, because Fastlane will be the Elimination Chamber. I believe I made Payback Backlash. So yeah, there's very minimal changes, but there's still some. Just gonna keep that in mind. Okay, here we go. Oh my god, look at that clothesline. We're now an arm drag. You know, it doesn't really get old when you're fighting Samoa Joe, does it? Oof. Jeez. I love the brutality of it all. Now some stomps. This just all feels correct. Oh. Yeah, nice bulldog. Now a little Jericho shuffle, as I'm gonna call it. I mean, I must say, I have been dominating this match the whole entire time. Here we go for this submission, which I've never seen used on a WWE show. I don't remember how long it's been on the games, but I've had to use that submission a handful of times. And let me just tell you, it's always been there for me. Always. Yeah. The professional Chris Jericho. But I must add the facts. Well, thanks for that. Oh god. Oof, man, the man just gave me a huge Samoan drop. I didn't enjoy that at all. I might actually end up losing this match now. Because now I'm struggling to really live here. Yeah, that's not good. Anyway, for the main event of part one of Battleground, we're gonna have Zanman versus Dean Ambrose for the Cruiserweight Championship. That should be interesting. Should be interesting as happens here. Oh, Lion Salt. Could this be it? Nope. Not it. You know, I honestly thought that I could be very close with that. But, you know, it just wasn't a... It just wasn't there for me. Okay, here we go. Here we're gonna hit the code breaker. Oh, yeah. Okay, is this it now? Will this be the end of Samoa Joe? Okay, I have no idea what to do now. Big splash, I don't know. Level drop. What's Jericho gonna do? Yep, gonna give a little taunt. Oh man, a moonsault out of all things. Come on. You gotta be kidding me, Joe. How can Samoa Joe survive this assault? Or was with Enziguri hit with the forearm, though. You know, it's something that I haven't done much of, and you're seeing a lot in this episode because I literally just started doing it. I mean, I think I did it in 15, but you know, I kind of just stopped. Was doing the strong strikes by holding down the square button. I think I was doing it in 15, but then I just completely forgot about it in 16. And now I am doing it now, so you know, it's still not too late. I forgot to do commentary, so, yeah. Just think about that one. Just think about that one. You got this nice little brief moment where I didn't say a word because I forgot to. I mean, I'm still beating up Samoa Joe, you know. He's starting to give me a run for my money. You know, he's a finisher now because I believe he just reversed the codebreaker. I forgot to actually pay attention, so, you know, we're just going to leave that one there. I'm just going to take this off the table. Maybe if I'm lucky, I can put him through the table. Oh, God. Oh, well, no, the monitors are just there, right? So, nice, I can put you through on the monitors. That will hurt. Hey, that's on 5 things you might not know about WWE 2K17 by, Smack Talks and the 101. 2 channels I'm subscribed to. Some of the first YouTubers I've ever watched. I mean, I'm subscribed to a handful, like Markiplier, Jacksepticeye, PewDiePie, and you know whatnot, but they're not even the first one, some of the first. I mean, you know, if you just want to hear something, because you know, why not? The first person I ever subscribed to was a guy named Affleck Cup Series. He's not even that popular. He has like a couple thousand subscribers, but you know, whatever. Samoa Joe's gonna count out right now. Oh, well, I missed that. Could be something that I need to use later in the match. You never know. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Oh, God. Buckle bomb right in the corner of the ring. Jeez. Well, I've never seen Samoa Joe do a buckle bomb, and, you know, frankly, I think it'd be more dangerous than Seth Rollins' buckle bomb. And, honestly, Samoa Joe's track record isn't too good lately. I mean, I know that he used to be, known as a really safe worker and all that, but as soon as he's been WWE, he's broke Tyson's kid's neck, and then he, injured Seth Rollins' knee, so not looking too good for him right now. Where's Bret Hart coming out on saying that Samoa Joe's dangerous? I mean, Rollins has injured three people, and Joe's injured two, but Rollins has also injured himself once. Himself, so I guess it's four. It all happens to the best of wrestlers. All I know is right now I could end up losing. Unless I start doing something drastic. Hey, stop chanting Jericho sucks. Okay, I take huge offense to this. Oh man, a baseball slide. Gonna see if I can get the count out victory here. Hey, I mean, you know, whatever it takes, so further the feud want. Count out victory. I mean, I know honestly what I'm talking about. You people might not, but I do. Another baseball slide. Yeah, there you go. There you go. I've just won by count of jerk and knows exactly what he's done. I must say, the baseball slide is very, very useful. You know, if you ever want to get those count out victories, you got to use the baseball slide to your advantage. You know, it's just complete honesty. If you know how to utilize the baseball slide, you can do whatever you want. Yeah. Hey, I mean, I must say, now the feud can end at SummerSlam. Alright, come on, that was awesome. That's like a high caliber match. What's that say right there? Does that say 4-star? It does say 4-star. Maybe. Yeah, it's 4-star. Okay, I mean, sure, it's not a 5-star matchup, but that's a pretty good match. It wasn't just a throwaway match. I mean, sure, the ending wasn't the best. The ending was not the best, okay? But it was still okay. And you have to remember that. Anyway, here we go. Kane is coming out to the ring right now. He's been in Universe Mode, WWE 2K17 Universe Mode before. It's just been a while. Here he comes to the ring anyway, and you might be wondering, oh man, who's Kane facing? Who can Kane possibly face? So I'm going to tell you, Kane is going to be facing the one and only Triple H, okay? Kane is facing Triple H. It's going to be great. I believe I am going as Triple H. Yeah, I believe I'm going as Triple H in this one. Even though, I mean, I like Kane more. Kane's my second favorite wrestler of all time. My first favorite of all time is The Undertaker, which is actually the current champion, who will be facing Edge in a no-holds-barred match in Part 2, which will be coming out tomorrow, and tomorrow is Saturday. So that's just something interesting to think about. Because, you know, why not? Anyway, here comes Triple H, and this is a classic Triple H. This is the current one. Just using classic Kane, because classic, everybody knows classic Kane is better than current Kane. And by everybody, I mean everybody. There's not a person alive who doesn't know that. Okay, here he is, the King of Kings. Cerebral Assassin. Game. What isn't Triple H? Anyway, here he comes. He's gonna do some damage to somebody. Somebody's gonna get beat up. Somebody's gonna be mauled by Triple H himself. Very interesting. You know, the problem I have this year is, I mean, Triple H is great and all. I mean, the problem I have with him this year is he's like a chicken. Because he would not come out and look Rollins in the face for months and months and months. And he finally does, and it's Mojo injures Seth Rollins. I mean, geez, Triple H only signed for like 3 more years, and you know, waiting for WrestleMania next year, if that's what they do, which is the stupidest idea I've ever heard. If they literally wait for WrestleMania next year, then what are you gonna do with a year-long feud? I mean, sure, Stone Cold and Vince McMahon worked for a year, but are you really gonna get Rollins and Triple H to work for a year? And especially in this day and age when wrestling is at the worst point it's ever been. I mean, don't get me wrong, wrestling's still, like, not bad in ratings, but it's at the worst it's ever been. There's only about, like, 2 million people seeing each show, but back in the day it was, like, 7 million, so it's changed. You know, it's really changed. But, you know, you don't have to worry about that. No. Not at all. Okay. I want to get this matchup underway here. Please. Okay, here we go. Kane's fixing the elbow pads he doesn't have. Triple H is shaking his wrist. We're going to actually start grappling to begin this match between Kane and Triple H. You know, I thought it to be... I was thinking that... That's a little bit weird for a Kane and Triple H match. But, you know, why not get technical? Why not get technical? Why not show off things that Triple H and Kane don't really do at all? There you go with the gigantic knee. Remember, everybody, that's how Seth Rollins broke John Cena's nose. I'm about to dive. There we go. That somehow worked. I think my knee might have hit him in the head before my hands hit him in the head. This is complete logic. Oh, come on. Huge DDT. Hey, if I'm lucky, I'll be able to get something going here. Maybe I can get something going here. Come on, Triple H. Come on. Another knee to the face. Come on. This match is so slow paced. I mean, you know, that's... I want to see Triple H in a nutshell, but... It's just, not quite working, is it? Oh, yes. Suplex, but bouncing Kane right off the ropes to assist me. Oh man, that huge DDT. This is looking mighty fine right now. I mean, you know, swing and a miss. Well, thanks for that. Thanks for that, Kane. Yeah, you know, it honestly means a lot to me. Hey, oh. This is nice. Oh, well. This is what I wanted to happen, totally. Okay, will this be it? No. No, the Spinebuster was not the tool to help me win. I must say, I am slightly parched. And talking in this video is not helping. Whatever. Okay. Well, there goes my idea, and I've just been tossed to the outside of the ring. Imagine in a Royal Rumble how useful that would be to reverse a rope move. Just toss somebody right over the rope. Okay, now Kane's back in the ring. I don't want a repeat of last match where there's a count-out victory, okay? I want a legit match. This can be the best one on the card. Here's a pedigree. Ah. This could be it. This could legitimately be it. He has enough damage. Nope, there's a rope break for some reason. Okay, first of all, the referee couldn't see it. And two, he wasn't touching the ropes. And I don't think his arm was under the ropes either. Hey, my leg's under the ropes. Is this not a rope break? I don't know what to do. Kane keeps kicking out. He hasn't reversed anything yet, so that's surprising. There we go. I have 90 punches. Throw you in the corner. Ooh, a snake eyes. And it makes him bleed too. Well, he just reversed the clothesline. And here I go. You know, that's nice. You think you're picking up momentum, but no. You know, you're just thrown out in the dust. Man, I gotta tell you, I thought I had this. I don't know what he just tried to do, but I just did the reverse RKO move. Now he just reversed the clothesline. Okay, this is starting to go wrong for me. And Kane has a signature. So, like I said, this is starting to go wrong for me. Maybe not, because now I'm in control again. And I'm about to get my signature. Here's another spine buster. I don't like the spine buster Triple H uses in this game. I mean, you know, that's just personally what I think. I want to see which one he had in the past games, because I want to change it bad. I really just don't like the spine buster uses in this game. And once you see Triple H in a match again, and you see him with a different spine buster, you're going to know exactly what I did. Here we go, here we go. Oh man, another pedigree. Come on, this has to be it. This has to be it. There's no way that he survived. There's no way he can live on to survive another day. 1, 2. Oh, come on. His hand touched the mat. I hate when that happens, when their hand touches the mat, but then it just gets it up a second, so he doesn't get to see 3. But there's still technically 3. Oh, man, a sidewalk slam. Well, now I'm in trouble. You could hit the choke slam or a tombstone or something. Kick out at 1. Or 4-1. The man could legitimately hit something and it could damage my life. He could end my career. I mean, he could definitely do something right now. I don't know what. Well, that's nice. I just took out the referee. How about a sledgehammer or a baseball bat or a steel chair or a table? Something I can do to really damage Kane. And it's a baseball bat. Let's see if I can hit him. Well, no. That didn't work. Just flew under the bottom rope. And now, this is backfiring. This is really backfiring. Oh! Wrestling takedown, the cane. Now a one knee camel clutch. Come on, Triple H, you can do this. Or not, I had to let go before he would, somehow reverse it. It's a strong strike to the back. Come on, this is definitely going well. This is an experience like none other. Oh. Come on, I'm literally getting destroyed here, okay. I was winning the match and now it's gonna be a huge what if I can muster the way to win. Okay, I just did a spinebuster the cane. Well, he reversed the pedigree, but that doesn't matter. I just flung him over the top rope, and now he has a finisher, which isn't good. God, I'm in jeopardy. I'm in jeopardy to end up losing the whole entire everything, okay? I'm going to lose everything I have. Why am I going to lose everything I have? Well, because I am. So, guys, I actually have to go now, so the rest of the video won't have commentary, because as you can tell, I'm recording commentary after. You probably didn't know, but I'm just going to straight up tell you now, this is the end of my commentary, please enjoy the rest of this video, and goodbye everybody.